Today I'm talking lipstick beauty tips and tricks for us over 50 gals. That's coming up next. Welcome back, I'm Kimberly. This is Pretty Over 50, where we talk everything makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman. I don't know about you, but my lips are not like they were when I was in my 30s. They're a little bit wrinklier, a little bit crinklier, and there's some lines around the top of them where I don't know where that came from. So if you're curious about how to best treat lips when you're a little bit older, I've got some great ideas I'll be sharing with you today. If you're new here, a very special welcome to you. I hope you'll consider subscribing and make sure you click that notification bell so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And if you're interested in more makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman, stop by prettyover50.com. There's a lot more great information just waiting for you there. I'm not sure what happened to my lips on the way to getting older, but they sure aren't what they used to be. They're a little bit thinner, there are these weird little lines all around them, and they're crinklier when I don't use some type of lip cream. So today I'll be sharing with you what I've found to be helpful tips and tricks for making my lips look the best that they can in my over 50 world. As always, all the products I'll be talking about today will be listed and linked below, and they'll also be over on the blog, so super easy for you to find. And with that, let's hop into it. There are really three areas that I look at when I'm thinking about how to best manage my over 50 more mature skin lips. The first one is the lines and skin around my lips. I've got these vertical lines on the top lip, and of course the skin around the edges of my mouth creases in a little bit more because I've got more wrinkles there and the dents in my marionette lines are deeper than they were. So I have a few things going on. First of all, those lines, my lipstick can travel up into those throughout the day, and also in the marionette area, if I put my lipstick on incorrectly, it will gather up towards the outside of my lips. I don't like either one of those. Dealing with that skin and getting a little bit more smooth was really one of my first priorities. What I feel has made a tremendous difference in the depth of those wrinkles on my lips, and they are better than they were, is dermarolling. If you're not familiar with dermarolling, I'll give you a little short explanation here, but I've also done a full video on it, and I'll go ahead and link it for you up here. A dermaroller is this tiny little tool, and don't worry, they're very, very reasonable. They're not expensive at all. And this little head has tiny, tiny little needles on it. Don't get scared, it doesn't hurt. And you roll this over your skin and it actually makes tiny punctures into your skin. I know that sounds scary, it's really not, which signals your skin to go in and heal it and produce more collagen. It creates a firmer look to the skin that you've run the dermaroller over. The caveat is it takes time for dermarolling really to show some results. So I'm probably very, very early in the stage of being able to see dramatic results in my dermarolling. However, I can say that since I started my skincare routine, the lines on my lips are less deep. I still have them, but they're not quite as outstanding and noticeable and deep as they were. And I really think that of all the things that I'm doing, the dermarolling is one of the most important ingredients. Dermarolling to really impact those wrinkles around our lips, I think, is one of the best things that we can do. The next step in lip care is moisturizing them, but before we moisturize, it's important to exfoliate and get all the dead skin cells off our lips. And I know I never thought about that. And to be honest with you, I probably don't exfoliate my lips as often as I should even now, even though I'm really aware of it. It's amazing that when I do exfoliate my lips, how much my lips really feel smoother and more youthful and more plump as a result of doing that. There's two exfoliators that I use. One is a drugstore solution and one is a little bit more high-end solution. The first one I'll show you is this little exfoliating lipstick from e.l.f. I love this and I actually keep it in the little basket that I keep on my couch with my tweezers and my nail clippers and my chapstick and that sort of thing. This stays in that basket. This twists up exactly like a lipstick does, and you can see it has that exfoliating cream inside as the lipstick. And you actually run this around your mouth and you can feel the little particles go onto your lips. And then I just massage them around with my finger and then wipe the whole thing off. It does a couple of things. It exfoliates my skin and it also moisturizes them from whatever is holding these particles. It's a moisturizing ingredient. These are only $2 or $3. I've probably had this about 8 months. Absolutely a great value, and you'll be surprised if you haven't exfoliated your lips what a difference you'll feel once you start doing it. The next popular product for exfoliating lips is a sugar scrub, and this is a sugar scrub from Hanalei that I've been using. Hanalei is a brand that I think we're going to be hearing a lot about. I think that they're going to be on par with Laneige as far as the quality of the lip products that they produce. This is their sugar lip scrub, and you can see it right in here. It's a thicker formula, and you just simply put your finger in it like that. You can see it on the end of my finger, and then you just rub that over your lips. And you can feel the little sugar granules as you rotate it around, and that's what's going to help lift off those dead skin cells on your lips. This formula is so lovely. It really is luxurious. And it smells like tropical fruit, like mangoes and papayas or something like that. I really, really enjoy this product, and it has a great moisturizing effect on my lips as well. Once your lips are all exfoliated, then you want to hydrate them or moisturize them. And I have three products that I'm really in love with right now that I use all the time. The first one is an oldie but goldie, and you probably already know about this. It is Aquaphor, and it comes in this tiny little squeeze tube. You can just squeeze a little bit out and put that over your lips, and it is so very moisturizing. This is a wonderful product to put on your lips before you go to sleep at night, and you'll wake up with very, very moisturized lips in the morning. Aquaphor is just a cult favorite. It's very inexpensive. You can get it almost anywhere. It does a wonderful job of moisturizing and is truly something that I always have in my skincare arsenal. The next lip moisturizer that I'm loving lately, and you guys know this, is this Nivea Blackberry Lip Cream. And I heard about this from Emily Noel, and I think she started an avalanche because it's getting a little hard to get. People are so in love with this formula. The cool thing about this Nivea is not only is it tremendously hydrating on your lips, very, very affordable. This particular one, the blackberry one, has a wonderful color that really puts a beautiful wash of kind of this plummy purpley color on your lips. And you can see it right here. This is what I reach for if I'm just running to the grocery store and I don't really want to put lipstick on, but I want a little bit of color on my lips. This formula is hydrating, it's smooth, it's lovely, and it leaves behind that nice berry flush of color that I think is so pretty. If you watch any of my Get Ready With Me's, this is usually what I'll put on my lips while I'm putting my makeup on. And I find that moisturizing my lips while I'm doing my makeup makes all the difference in the lipstick application at the end of my makeup routine. The more bougie high-end lip treatment that I am loving is also from Hanalei, and this is their lip treatment in the color Clear. This is so wonderful. It is a luxurious lip moisturizing cream. Again, you just squeeze it up, put a little bit on your finger. This particular one is clear, and I believe it comes in other colors. And when I put this on my lips before I go to bed at night, oh golly, it just feels like luxury. It feels a little bit like a spa treatment on my lips. And I truly believe that this lip cream from Hanalei is probably going to become what people compare Laneige to. It is luxurious. It has a wonderful light scent to it. It does a wonderful job of moisturizing your lips, and I just think it's a really quality product. We've addressed the skin around our lips and how to make it look a little more youthful, how to actually work with the skin on our lips by exfoliating the old dead skin cells and hydrating the new skin cells and plumping up our lips. I know that when I moisturize my lips look a lot plumper. Now that being said, my lips are thinner than they were when I was in my 30s. They just don't have the volume that they used to. So applying lipstick in a different way has become very important for me to be able to create a look where my lips look a little bit plumper than they actually are. I've also noticed that when I don't apply my lipstick correctly, I'll get lipstick that will bunch up in the corners of my mouth, which is not a look I'm going for. I can remember seeing my old aunts at family reunions having that lipstick clump up there, and now I've become them. Love them to death, but I didn't want that lipstick look. What I'm going to do now is take off the lipstick I've got on and show you how I apply my lipstick now to kind of avoid some of those issues that I have now that my lips are a little bit more mature. One product that I almost always use with my lipsticks is a lip liner. I've noticed that when I use a lip liner, my lipstick will travel up into those lines on my lips a little bit less. I've also noticed that the creamier the lip liner pencil, the more the lipstick will travel, or the less that lip liner will keep it from traveling. The stiffer the formula or the more wax in it, the more that it will hold the lipstick down into my lips. This particular liner is from Rimmel and it's about right in the middle. So I do have to keep an eye on it to make sure that my lipstick is not traveling up into those lines throughout the day. However, it does give a nice boundary around my lips and I'm able to expand the area of my lips using a lip liner. I don't actually line the outside of my lips. I line the outside of the outside of my lips. The little line that we have around our lips, I believe it's called the Vermilion line, where I think we're the only ones that have it. I'll make sure that I run my lip liner on the outside of that line. I'm lining the outside of my lips, and that's helping my lips look a little bit plumper. I'll try to do it here so you guys can see. So you can see right here, this is the lip that's lined, the side that's lined, and this is the side that isn't lined. So I've taken that lip liner up above that outside edge of the lip and lined that area. And you can see that this side of my lip looks a little bit bigger or plumper. The next thing I do when I line my lips is I don't bring the liner or the lipstick down to the corner of my mouth. It is so heavy in there with the skin coming together because my skin is not as taut as it used to be, that if I do that, the lipstick really gathers in the corner of my mouth. And I've seen it on a few videos and it's just like, oh my goodness. Once you see a picture of yourself with that, it really teaches you the lesson. What I do with the lip liner is I actually stop it and bring it in a little bit before I get to the corner of my mouth. I'll do that now and show you how it looks. So you can see right here, I've actually brought that liner in before the corner of my mouth, and that's going to keep that lipstick from collecting in the corners, and it's also going to make my lip look a little bit plumper because my lip area is not so wide. I'll go ahead and finish lining the other side of the top lip. And you can see with both sides that I've actually cut the lip line in a little bit before my lip gets to the actual corner. For the bottom lip, I do the same thing. I cut it in a little bit from the edge of my lip and bring it down and below the bottom edge of my lip. So I'm expanding it below the bottom edge. I'll show you one side compared to the other. So there is the bottom lip half lined, and you can see I brought that lip liner into the edge before it gets to the corner of my mouth. And you can see right here how my bottom lip, I've got that lined below the lower edge. You can see how that makes my lip look a little bit fuller and plumper. So now I have my lips all lined. Time to go in with the lipstick. This lipstick is Lacquered Strawberry. This is from the L'Oreal Color Riche line. I love this line of lipsticks. I wish I could own every single one of them. You can see it's a beautiful strawberry pink color, and the last thing I want is for that pink color to be running up into my lip lines because it would really show up, which is why I want to make sure that I have a very strong liner around my lips. I'm just going ahead and take that formula and just fill in that lip area that I've already outlined. And there we have it, lips that look a little fuller and plumper than they actually are in reality. I hope you enjoyed this lipstick beauty tips and tricks for us over 50 gals with more mature skin and lips that aren't quite like they used to be. If you found it useful and helpful, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, a very special welcome to you. Make sure you smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. And if you're interested in more makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman, stop by prettyover50.com. There's a lot more great information just waiting for you there. I want to thank you so much for joining me. It just tickles me when you take a few minutes out of your day to spend it with me. I appreciate that, and I appreciate you. Again, I'm Kimberly. This is Pretty Over 50, where we talk everything makeup, skincare, and style for the over 50 woman. Make it a great day, wear your sunscreen, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye now.